Dog fanciers, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to talk about whippets versus small pets. And in other words, can you keep whippets and small pets in the same household? What to expect and what behaviors to watch out for? But before we get started, I want to ask you a question. Do you have other pets apart from dogs? Leave a comment into the comment section and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet. Let's get into the video. First things first, I know that some people are afraid to bring in a whippet because they already own small pets and the other way around. And this is because whippets are known for chasing and sometimes killing small animals because if you think about it, this is what the breed was selected for. But I'm here to tell you that of course whippets and small pets can live together happily ever after without you having that much to worry about. We have had all types of small pets together with our whippets, from Persian cats to hamsters, and I have never had to worry about anything. And at the moment we have 4 rats and they're all girls. So before I show you footage of my rats and my whippets and the behaviors that you can expect from your whippet, I want to highlight an important note. All small pets except for cats should not be left free roaming in the presence of a sighthound. If there is a designated area for that pet to free roam, the whippet should learn not to enter that area and not to have a close contact with a small pet. And the owner should not put their pets into unnecessary risky situations. Other than that, almost any whippet would be excited when the small pet is brought into the household, but they tend to settle quickly afterwards and they get used to the fact that these will be look, no touch pets. And will most probably start acting like they don't even notice them. So some of the videos were filmed during the day, which was a fairly unusual time for the rats to be let out, because usually we let them out between 9 and 11 p.m. So they were not really willing to cooperate at the daytime videos, but I have some nighttime videos where they're a little bit more active. So let's start with the safer behaviors first. Our adult whippets are very used to the rats being around. They couldn't care less about the rats and they're in no way interested in their business. I can safely keep them in the room while the rats are free roaming in their designated area without me having to constantly watch them. This usually is a stage that comes after the first hype of you bringing a small pet into the household of your whippet, and is also a very typical behavior for whippets that are more grown up and more laid back. And by the way, this is also a reason why I restrict the close contact between the rats and the whippets. The rats do that even when the whippet is just sniffing through the cage. So moving on to the less safe behaviors that are coming from the infant members of the pack here, also known as my 16-month-old puppies. So Jamie is very used to the rats and honestly, she's way too lazy to do anything other than observing, but sometimes she gets triggered. This is a very predictable behavior though, still nothing to worry about, and she usually just ends up laying down and watching. Ivy is the next level of hysterical but predictable. She has a bunch of butterflies flying around in her head. She really, really wants them. If that escalates, she's asked to leave the room, of course, but usually she gives up and leaves the room on her own or just ends up laying on the bed watching them from there. And now I'm going to show you something that looks like a very, very safe behavior, but actually that is the whippet I'm most cautious with, Ruby. It looks like she's just watching, I know. But do not be fooled, she is a mastermind of a hunter. She calculates every single move of her prey and acts accordingly. She is very patient and shows barely any interest. But with that same behavior, she catches flies and fast insects in the garden. With the same speed, I eat popcorn. And sometimes she even tries to catch birds, and we fear one day she might. But of course, we try to prevent that anytime we see her trying to hunt down a bird. She knows she's not allowed in where the rats are running around, but if I leave the room, I might return to see she has collected all the rats in the span of a minute. So once these Whippet kids grow up mentally, they will most probably stop paying attention to the rats and will also act like they don't even notice them. So my point here is that you can safely keep Whippets and small pets in the same household. As long as you're cautious, of course, and you take the necessary measures to ensure the safety of the small pet. And as I have previously said, do not worry to get a Whippet or a small pet just because you have the other. Everything is going to be alright. For all the years we have had Whippets with small pets, because we've never had just Whippets, I have never had to worry about anything, and I've never been scared that something would go wrong. So I hope you found this video informative and that you learned something new, and also that you feel more positive about keeping Whippets and small pets under the same roof. So thank you so much for watching, have a wonderful weekend and an even better week, and I will see you next Friday with a new video. Bye bye!